Many people ignore constipation, thinking it's just uncomfortable or annoying. But did you know it could actually trigger your pain and anxiety? The way your gut works and the bacteria living there can influence how your body feels pain and even how your brain handles stress. In this video, I'll explain the connection between bowel habits, gut health, and chronic pain, and what you can do about it. So let's talk about the connection between bowel movements and chronic pain today. Research shows that constipation is not just uncomfortable, it can actually make your pain worse. In 2018, researchers published a study that examined 365 patients with chronic pain, including headache, neck, back, chest, abdominal, and leg pain. The participants were evaluated based on the stool consistency and constipation state. The stool consistency was assessed by the Bristol Stool Form Scale, or BSFS, which is a graded visual scale of stool from type 1, meaning hard to pass, to type 7, which is the fluid kind. The relevance of this scale is that it shows the participants drawing stool shapes together with precise descriptions regarding form and consistency and using easily recognizable examples, like separate hard lumps, like nuts. The stool type 1 and 2 are considered abnormally hard stools. Types 3, 4, and 5 are generally considered normal stool form, especially the type 4. And types 6, the fluffy pieces with ragged edges and mushy stools, and 7, watery, are abnormally liquid stools, designated as diarrhea. Constipation was rated with the Cleveland Clinic Constipation Score, CCCS. It consists of 8 factors: frequency of bowel movements, difficulty, effort, completeness, pain, and time that it takes to do it, and the assistance if they need, failure attempts per every 24 hours, and history or duration of constipation. The researchers who conducted that study found that people with constipation reported more severe pain, especially in the lower back, legs, but also in the whole body. Interestingly, the type of stools, whether it was hard or soft, didn't seem to affect pain levels. So even if your stool isn't hard, constipation could still be linked to a worse pain. Constipation affects 55 million Americans, or 28% of the US population. It affects 12% of men, 16% of women, and 40% of elderly individuals. And I will include links to these studies in the description below. In primary constipation, there are mainly 2 causes. The first one is a problem with the muscles that coordinate the abdomen, rectum, and pelvic floor. This is called dyssynergic defecation. And second is a slow transit constipation. Now, there are secondary constipations. This can be many causes, secondary causes: dietary, like low fiber diet, or side effects of medications, or neurologic, like spinal cord injury, Parkinson's disease, or even metabolic causes, like diabetes. When should you be concerned about constipation? Constipation can be a sign of a serious health condition, and these are the signs to pay attention and seek medical care. If there is unintentional weight loss, or if the person had normal bowel movements the whole life and now constipation starts at an older age, if there is a family history of cancer, inflammatory bowel disease, or celiac disease, if there is blood in the stools or spontaneous bleeding from the rectum. Remember, this video is not intended to provide medical advice. It's for educational purposes only. And if you have any emergency, please go to the nearest emergency department or call an ambulance. So why does constipation affect pain? One reason might be the gut microbiome, the trillions of bacteria living in your intestines. Your gut bacteria don't just help with digestion, they also communicate with your brain through the gut-brain axis. These bacteria produce chemicals like serotonin, which you may have heard is important for mood. The gut has three main functions: motility, secretion, and visceral sensitivity. Serotonin is involved in all three functions. Serotonin is the primary neurotransmitter regulating bowel activity. Here is a surprising fact: 90% of all serotonin in your body is in your guts, not in your brain. Serotonin helps regulate digestion, pain perception, mood, and even thinking. When your gut bacteria are out of balance, what scientists call dysbiosis, your body may produce less serotonin. Lower serotonin can contribute to constipation, worsen pain, and even affect mood and anxiety. In people with chronic pain, the body's natural pain control systems, which rely on serotonin and other chemicals, don't work so well. This is especially true in conditions with widespread pain, like fibromyalgia. Constipation and an imbalanced gut microbiome may disrupt these natural pain control systems, creating a vicious cycle. Constipation worsens gut imbalance, and gut imbalance reduces natural pain control. Reduced pain control increases pain. Increased pain may worsen constipation. It's a cycle that affects both physical and mental well-being. People with constipation report more psychological distress, mood problems, and restriction of physical and social activities. If you find this video helpful, please like, share, and subscribe for more tips on managing chronic pain naturally. Now, what are treatment options for constipation? If I tell you that there is one single treatment that can increase serotonin in the guts and also improve motility, would you accept that treatment? And if you ask me about side effects, there are none. And if you ask me about the scientific evidence, yes, there is scientific evidence, some evidence to suggest it's beneficial for constipation. And what is the cost? Completely free. One way to break the constipation cycle is through physical activity. Constipation is often linked to not enough movement and spend too much time sitting. Even mild to moderate exercise like walking or gentle stretching can help bowel movements. Exercise also reduces pain severity in chronic pain patients. How? Exercise activates the body's natural pain control and may even improve the balance of gut bacteria. So staying active not only helps your bowel movements, but it also reduces pain and improves mood. It's also important to remember that some medications for pain can cause constipation. Drugs commonly used for pain or nerve symptoms like opioids, pregabalin, and certain antidepressants can slow bowel movements. In one study, most medications didn't differ much between patients except for acetaminophen, which showed some differences in how often it was used. But if you take these medications and have constipation, it's worth talking to your doctor about strategies to protect your gut health. So what can you do if you have chronic pain and constipation? Here are some practical tips. 1. Stay hydrated. Aim for 6 to 8 glasses of water a day. Eat enough fiber, fruits, vegetables, oats, psyllium supplements can help. Move your body. Even gentle daily activity improves bowel movements and pain. Respond to urges. Don't ignore the urge to go. And check your medications. Ask your doctor if any may be contributing to constipation. If these lifestyle changes are not enough to treat constipation, the person may talk to their pharmacist to get over-the-counter medications. For example, fibers to increase stool's volume, bulking agents, or stool softeners. If they need a prescription medication, they can talk to the doctor. Some options include osmotic laxatives like lactulose or polyethylene glycol, also stimulant laxatives like bisacodyl, cascara, and senna. In people who have a problem with pelvic floor muscles, they may need muscle retraining, and this can be done with a pelvic floor physiotherapist or biofeedback. Pelvic floor dyssynergia is not uncommon and it may be a cause of chronic constipation. This happens when the anal sphincter has a spasm, so it cannot relax when the person is trying to defecate. In these cases, giving laxatives, more fiber, or increasing physical activity will not solve the problem. They need to learn to coordinate the muscles of the abdomen, rectum, and anal sphincter. We learn this coordination when we are toddlers, so it is really important to help children to relax and use proper positioning when they are creating these habits. If you want to complete those questionnaires that I mentioned in this video, to show to your doctor, to maybe talk to them about the form of your stools or the constipation questionnaire, I'll put a link on my website and you can download a free handout, a one-page handout to download, complete those questions and show to your doctor next time that you see them and talk about if you have constipation or not and what you could do about it. Remember, constipation is common, but it's not just uncomfortable. It can affect your pain and mental health. By improving gut health and bowel habits, you may notice less pain, better mood, and more energy. Simple changes in diet, activity, and gut care can make a real difference. If you have chronic pain and constipation, don't ignore it. Take small steps to increase your gut health. It can help to reduce pain and improve your overall well-being. Send this video to someone that you know who needs to learn more about constipation and chronic pain. And thank you for watching. Goodbye.